Hey everybody, it's John Tinker. John, welcome to the shop. Real quick project today, and that's putting in this heater. A little bit about my shop here. If you followed along, it's a metal building that I had built. It's only 8x16s, perfect for my size since I build the small models and engines and so forth. And it's big enough for everything in here. It is a little difficult with those little 1500 watt heaters. It doesn't get that cold here in Texas, but we can get down in the 20s sometime, and those little 1500 watt heaters just don't seem to do the job. So what I did, I bought one of these Comfort Zone heaters. You've seen them all over the internet. I thought I'd just give a real quick review on how it's done within this small shop of mine. Now, as I said before, this shop is 8x16. It does have insulated ceiling. It's got insulated walls in it. And the floor is not insulated, but it does have the walls and ceiling. I only have two windows and one door in the shop to give you an idea of the space that I have here. So, you know, 8x16, you can figure it up. This should be more than enough. Now, this is a Comfort Zone heater, and I'll leave the link down below. And you know the story about the links down below. That means I'm an Amazon associate. Get a little kickback if you order one of those. But this is Comfort Zone. The company, nobody makes this stuff, of course. You just see their name plastered everywhere. But this is you've seen that Comfort Zone on those little 1500 watt heaters. They're just all over the place. Walmart, Lowe's, a lot of places sell that brand name for whatever it's worth. They're all out of China. But Comfort Zone actually makes, I believe, three of these sizes. This is the smallest one, and this is a 5,000 watt heater. It's 220, so I went ahead and I wired it up. I got the fuse box in the back. It's not going to be an illustration on wiring. It is easy to wire. If you're not comfortable doing that, of course, call an electrician. But all you have to do is just add an extra 30 amp break it to 220 breaker to your circuit, and it does run on 240 volts. So I give you a real quick review of the install and then what I think about it. Well, I've got everything out of the box. It wasn't anything about the unboxing. It comes with only about three things. You get a couple of lag screws to put it into the ceiling or wherever you want to put it at. It's got an 11-page instruction book. 9.5 pages are don't electrocute yourself, don't blow yourself up. It does have a bracket that you hang from the ceiling. And then it's got the heater unit itself. Now, it was all wrapped up in nice, pretty plastic and all, but I've already taken all that off. Now, the next thing I've got to do is go ahead and take the bottom off of it and get it ready to do the wiring. All right, the next thing you can see, the bracket is mounted, and the instructions will tell you how far you need to get it away from the wall, from the ceiling, and so forth. And that meets those specifications right there. But that's all it is. Two screws hold it up. It's also got a hole in the middle of the bracket if you want to put it to where you can swivel it from one side to the other. But in my situation, that's going to work out just fine. Well, that's what's underneath the heater, and that's what it looks like. And again, make sure that you're comfortable wiring this up. If not, make sure that you get somebody to do it for you. It does have a wiring diagram on the bottom of it. There's just screws holding this bottom on. And essentially what you do, you've got line one, line two coming in right here, and then right over here you got ground. Again, make sure you're comfortable doing this, or either go ahead and get you an electrician if you need to do this. But it's fairly simple to hook up. There is one thing that a little concerning, and this is just a characteristic of this heater. May not be able to focus but where this is the thermostat as well as your master power switch. I would rather have a wall thermostat, but you know, when you'd rather have stuff, sometimes it costs money, and my rather have is kind of limited. So that's part of being retired. So you make do. If that doesn't work, I'll go ahead and spend a dollar or two and I'll get me a 240 volt. This requires a 240 volt thermostat if you want a wall thermostat, or you'll either have to put a 24 volt transformer and like a regular heater thermostat on it. But there's plenty of room inside here if you ever wanted to do that. All right, that's enough about that. Well, that's it. Overall, very happy with the heater. One thing I wish it would do, I wish it had the external thermostat on it that you could put on the wall As I said, you can't add an external thermostat without going through a 24-volt transformer, or you have to find a baseboard heater thermostat for a 240-volt thermostat. But it's not a deal breaker. It's just more of an inconvenience. With the thermostat right here on the bottom of it, behind here is where the thermostat is, so it does tend to kick off. Now, how does it perform here in the shop? Well, it does extremely well. Outside, I can bring it up from the 30s and 40s within 10 or 15 minutes. I kick it all the way up at 5,000 watts, then put it back down to 3,000 or 4,000. It has three levels, 3,000, 4,000, 5,000. Normally, I just keep it on 3,000 watts once it warms up. So if you have a small shop, I don't know how big you can go on this thing, but if you have a small one, if you're probably in Texas, it would probably do a two-car garage, probably be stretching it at that. You might want to go to the bigger one. If you're up north somewhere, obviously you're going to need to go bigger. But for small shops, and the main thing is it helps keep all this iron in here warm when I come out here. I don't have to spend all the money and all that time warming up a bunch of cast iron in the shop. So that's it. I hope you got something out of it. Once again, links down below if you'd like to investigate these heaters anymore. Until we meet again, Tinker John from the Upper East Side of Texas. Y'all be careful, take care, and God bless.